Well, so many people think of his legacy as the pioneer of indexing or low-cost indexing. He's really so much more. He's really what this award is about, putting the client first.
Putting the client. He always talked about giving the investor a fair shake.
That's exactly.
And that is what you all have striven to do through low fees. But how much lower can fees go, Tim?
Well, we're built to drive them lower and lower. In index funds, a lot of people have matched us on fees, but fees can come down a lot more in active management, in places like advice. In fact, Morningstar did a study, and they looked at fees across complexes, and our nearest competitor is still twice our fee level.
And yet some of your big competitors have come in with zero fee entries in the past year. That must have shaken you up a little bit.
Well, we look at it. For us, low cost is an investment philosophy. It's not a marketing ploy. So it's one thing. If you have one fund that's a low fee, look at the rest of your portfolio. It has to be low as well.
What does stewardship mean to you?
It means putting the client's interest first in everything you do and making sure that, hey, it's easier for us. Maybe I should explain our structure.
Yeah.
Our structure.
Which is different from
most
other companies.
It is very different. We're actually owned by our clients. So our clients own our funds and the funds own Vanguard, which means we don't serve anyone from the outside, public shareholders, private families. We only serve our clients. They are our shareholders. They are the owners of Vanguard. So when we have a good year, what we do is we share that with them in two ways. One.
Keeping costs down.
Yeah, we give them back profit in the form of lower expense ratio. And we can reinvest in the business, better services for them.
All right, let's turn to the news of the day. There is a big trade deal that is either going to happen or it's not going to happen or whatever. We don't know.
I feel like I've heard that before.
We don't know what's going to happen. What's your best advice to investors today in light of the turmoil and turbulence, not just with the trade deal, but with North Korea, with Iran, and other things?
So I'd say stay diversified. It's your best defense. You know, I'm around the markets all the time. I've met a lot of brilliant people. I've yet to meet the person who can see the future. And from that perspective, just keep your asset allocation. Stick with it. You have your bonds in your portfolio for ballast during a storm.
I want to get your reaction to something that the president apparently said just moments ago. And that is that in terms of economic risk to the United States, the U.S. Federal Reserve is a greater risk than the tariff tussle between us and China. How do you react to that?
The Federal Reserve has done a wonderful job. If you look through time, what they did through the financial crisis to today, and you know they have to really focus on what's best for the economy, and they have that singular focus of what's going to be better for the economy of the U.S. and for the job market long term. They've done a nice job of trying to tune out the noise.
So you think they're doing that? You do not see them then. I'm putting words in your mouth, and you're free to distance yourself from them. But you do not see the Federal Reserve as a primary risk to the U.S. economy, even greater than China.
I think they do their best to figure out what is the information out there. Look at that information. How do we actually keep prices stable, maybe growing just a little bit? And how do we maximize employment? And if you look towards that, they've done a nice job on the employment side. And sure, people might want a little bit more inflation, but man, it beats the deflationary risk we had a few years back. They've done a nice job. And you know, my advice then would tune out the noise, keep thinking long term.
Does it trouble you at all that the administration seems to be critical of the Fed, trying to maneuver it in a direction, or does this just come with the territory?
Well, I'll leave that between the White House and the Fed. I'll leave that debate between them.
How do you guys, as you look at Vanguard versus all of the other competition, you're the ones who are bringing in the most assets. Why?
It's the value proposition. 90%, you look over 10 years, 90% of our funds have outperformed their competition. We offer our funds at about a fifth the industry expense ratio. And our service, if you look at our loyalty scores, they're twice our nearest competitor. So that's a pretty powerful value proposition. I mean, how many companies out there give you the highest performing product at the lowest cost? You'll have a tough time naming more than two or three.